I primed my face off camera. Now I'm going to start on the eyes. For my eye look today, I think I'm going to use this palette. It's from Black Heart. It's a Hot Topic brand, and I just recently found this palette, so I'm pretty much just trying it out. So I'm gonna use some of the shades that are in here for the look that I'm going for today. I'm going to take the brown shade right here. It's a matte, light brown matte color. I'm just going to go over my eyelid just like a base color. Underneath my eye, I'm going to add this red eyeshadow from Hot Topic, and I'm taking this angled eyeshadow brush right here, and I'm going to go under the eye to give it a more bloodshot, irritated look. With a darker brown tone from the palette. It's right here next to the black. You can barely see it in the lighting. That's right here, and I'm going to go over my eyelid pretty much over the base color. I'm going to take the black at the end of here and add some black ever so slightly in the corner here, just to give it like a little bit of definition, and like around my eye right here, like kind of like an eyeliner, but not like really, just to give it like some definition. Step that I'm doing is just taking some mascara, and I'm lightly going to go over my eyelashes. With this look, I don't really think that you need eyeliner and all that. You don't want to mess up, you know, what you've done already. You just want to go in with some mascara, and I'm taking the Colossal Big Shot mascara and just going to go over it slightly. Not a lot. You want to kind of look like you have natural eyelashes, just like a little bit more enhanced. Not too much. You don't want to overdo it. You don't want to look too made up, you know? Just nice. See? Not too much. You can't see, but like, you don't want to overdo it. Or you'll just look too... Going back in with the red shade that I used, I'm ever so slightly going to go into my eyebrows and take this eyeliner brush and just give my eyebrows like a little tint. Just not a whole bunch. You don't want to overdo it, obviously, because you're just gonna look, I don't know, kind of weirdish. You just want to give them like a reddish tint. Not where you're gonna look crazy, like craziness. Just a little bit. You don't wanna go in too much into your red either. You don't wanna oversaturate your brush, because that can be bad too. You just don't need that in your life, pretty much. Just a little bit does go like a long way, depending on what brand of red you're using. Mine, I kind of have to dip in like a little bit more, but not much. There. Just a red tint, because my hair is red, so just like a red tintish color. don't really want to overdo this look. So a simple foundation, maybe like a lighter shade than you normally are, will work out fine. I think this one's like kind of light for me, so it'll work out pretty well. You kind of want to look like you're palish. You know, it's okay if you look pale or whatever. And then a simple setting powder will do the trick. So you don't really need a lot for this look. It's not super glamorous. It's just like pretty much basic, easy. And that's what you want. You want to look pretty simple. You know what I mean? You don't want to do too much. For lipstick, you could either go with a nice tan, peachy, glossy color like this from NYX, you know, a more natural shade, or you can, you know, snazz it up a little bit and use a red shade. I think I might use this red shade from L'Oreal. It's from the Infallible Paints collection. It's the shade DIY Red. I'm going to use this for my lips. I'm going to add a extra touch to the look and add some scars. And I got these at Dollar General. You get two for a dollar in a package. So I'm just going to cut some of these out and just strategically place them in certain areas of my face. And you can cut them down to size, like however your, you know, face shape is. You can just cut them down, you know, and make them work with your face shape and your, I guess, body type, whatever, wherever you put them at, you know what I mean? You can just trim them down like so. How you can even cut them in half, you know, just feel free to do like whatever you want with them, pretty much. They're like a fun little addition to your look. Okay guys, well, I'm just filming this in the bathroom because it's like better lighting, but this is the final look. And I got this dress at Hot Topic like a long time ago, and that's the makeup right here. I added this cute little bow that I got at Walmart last year. And if you want to, you can add some final touch to the outfit. And you can add like some blood. Well, I don't have blood, but I have ketchup. That's a secret thing you can use if you, you know, can't go and get blood or it's sold out somewhere. You can just use basic ketchup. So kind of convenient. Now I'm gonna just show you what it looks like. So this is how it looks with like ketchup if you don't have fake blood from like the store. It kind of has like a yellowish tone, but like it's okay. And recommendation, don't put it on your nose or you're just gonna look at that all the time. But yeah, you just want to smear it, and you can rub it on your arms, everywhere, you know, it's like right there, like just everywhere. And make sure it doesn't get on your dress, obviously. You don't want it, even though it has like blood stains on it, you don't want it to, you know, be a part of your dress, like the ketchup. So yeah, this is my, I don't know, killer cutie costume idea. So if you like this video, please give it a like, comment, share, and subscribe, and I'll talk to you guys all next time. Bye, everyone.